sometimes pretty ugly. Sometimes love is pretty, sometimes pretty ugly.
I'm Evangelist Earl Harris, Jr. of the We Win Glad Tidings Hour. We will be coming to you each week from Global Life Park in Arlington, Texas. Log in to hear us. I truly believe that you'll be blessed. I truly believe that you'll be inspired by the Word of God. The Bible says in Matthew 4:4, Luke 4:4, Deuteronomy 8:3, that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded or goeth out of the mouth of God. We will bring to you songs of inspiration, prayers that will bless you. Whatever your needs are, whatever you're going through, we believe God for a miracle, and that you'll be blessed and inspired and leave away different from the way you came. God bless you.
On FishbowlRadioNetwork.com. Jump in.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lasagna Ivory, and I am running for Duncanville ISD School Board Place 4. I have been an educator for more than 20 years. The value I place on education is demonstrated in my personal academic accomplishments, my relationships with students, parents, teachers, and other stakeholders. As a member of Duncanville ISD School Board, I will unapologetically focus on academic achievement. Vote for Dr. Lasagna Ivory for Duncanville ISD School Board Place 4, Election Day, May 2nd, 2020, and early voting begins April 20th. I'm not just passionate, I'm prepared. I'm Lasagna Ivory, and I approve this message.
Hi, this is Joe Mass. You are listening to the Queen Silvy Show. You are now part of the royalty.
Welcome to the Queen Silvy Show. Tune in 11. Good laugh, good vibe, that's for sure. Get smooth with Tim, get smooth with Tim. They have you running like you popped a pill. Once you hear the show, you ain't gonna want it to end. Get creative with the sounds, you can make it your mouth. Reaching all over the world, Queen Silvy in the house. Award-winning show with the number one spot, look out. It's the Queen Silvy Show, it's the Queen Silvy Show. It's the Queen Silvy Show, it's the Queen Silvy Show. It's the Queen Silvy Show, it's the Queen Silvy Show. It's the Queen Silvy Show, look out.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live on the Fishbowl Radio Network from the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex, it's the Queen Silvy Show, starring Smooth Tim and the magical, magnificent, magnanimous Queen herself, Queen Silvy.
Good morning, and this is Smooth Tim, and welcome to a terrific Tuesday on the Queen Silvy Show. It is now my absolute pleasure to introduce to you everyone's favorite comedian, world's sexiest granny, Queen Silvy.
Keep telling it like it is. That's right. This is Queen Silvy, and thank you all for tuning in to the Queen Silvy Show. It is a lovely day here in Arlington, Texas, as I look out the window and see the birds smiling. Look, there they go as they fly by. Now, without further ado, allow me to introduce my buddy pal and co-host of the years, Smooth Tim. Hey, Tim.
Good morning, Queen, and how are you doing?
As always, supercalifragilistic.
Expialidocious, yes. I suppose. It's yes, 24/7, 365. Mm-hmm. Queen Silvy, yes. Should I mention that you are simply amazing? Right? Yes, you are.
Can't help it. I am amazing. Keeping it real. Keeping it real. But what else is amazing, Smooth, is my amazing guest on the show today, don't we?
Indeed. On today's show, Queen, we have inspirational, motivational speaker, Chassidy. Yes. We also have, from Unique catering and party planning owner Donna Sellers.
Yes, she'll be here momentarily.
And NFL footballer coming in to sit with us during the off season, I guess.
Hey,
Josh Stewart.
Yes.
You'll be our little surprise guest. If you didn't know it, now you do.
Now you know.
And also life coach Devon Coleman is in studio with us. And let me get some reminders out, Queen, real quick. Our thoughts and prayers go out to the world right now.
Absolutely.
With the coronavirus and what's going on and all this social segregation and everything else, please, a couple of things. Take good care of yourself. Wash your hands.
Absolutely.
Wash your face. You've heard it a million times. Find something to keep yourself active. I don't care if you play solitaire, but communicate. It says social segregation, not social inactivity. So you can call your family. You can call your friends. Have some FaceTime and at least keep yourself out there, but stay safe. And if you are not feeling well, please do segregate yourself from the public.
You know what? I say faith over fear.
Faith over fear sounds
because,
like a plan,
you know,
to me.
Yeah, you don't want me to get
this too. We shall overcome, Queen.
Yes, it shall.
Well, let me get some shout outs on our analytics from last week's show.
Mm-hmm.
The United States, Australia,
shout
United
out.
Kingdom.
Yes.
Germany, New Mexico,
shout
Ireland.
Out to you.
Venezuela, France, Singapore, Africa. We appreciate you turning in
Thank
into
you
the
much.
Show. Thank you so very, very.
Spread the word.
Very much.
Spread
no matter
word.
What time of the day or night it is, even though it is a different day in some parts of the
That's
world.
That's right. We
Thank
are here
you.
For you. Any more?
That is just about, oh, yeah, I almost forgot. And I would have been in so much trouble with you. We are actually doing a book drive here at Fishbowl Radio Network.
Yes, we are.
And so we can help educate our youth. So if you have some books, hopefully new books, that you would like to drop off to the Queen Silvy Show at Fishbowl Radio Network, give you an opportunity to stop in at Globe Life Park and drop those books off.
Well,
1000
you know,
Ballpark Way, Arlington, Texas.
The books that we are looking for, actually, Smooth, are books from 0 to 5 years old. We're trying to touch bases with the real young youth. So if you have any books available, gently used or new, we'll gladly accept them for the month of March. And we are always making a difference. And I'm making a difference for you right now because I would love before
Wait a minute. Speaking of making a difference, what about the Queen Silvy Show Friends Club, Queen?
Keep it going, baby.
We forgot to tell them about the Queens. We have all kinds of really nice gifts that sponsors have given us. Could be a meal, could be a little present.
That's right.
We just have this incessive need to give
I
it
love
away.
Giving things away. What
yeah,
I, say?
I don't know why that is, but we like giving stuff away, except coronavirus. We don't like giving that away.
Well,
we'll
I don't
keep
have that,
that to ourselves, but
so.
I don't even want it in the first place. But in any regards, if you'd like to be included on our giveaway list, email us at queensylvy@comic.com.
That is so correct.
That'll
Please
wrap it up,
do.
Queen.
All right, thank you very much. We are currently going live on Facebook under Silvy Starks. You're more than welcome to log on there and see our beautiful queens that is here in studio. Spread the word because we are also going live right now at www.fbrn.us, and that's where you can listen to us live here. What I'd like to do before I begin my conversation with the beautiful queen, Chassidy Young, is I want to tell you that you're more than welcome actually to call in. The lines are open. If you'd like to call in, ask a question, give a shout out, or holler at a girl, you know me, you gotta take that chance. I might holler back at you, but take that chance. The number to do it on is 214-431-5032. Before I begin my conversation with Queen Chassidy, what I'd like to do is I'd like to share some motivational words from the Queen Silvy Show to you. What you tell yourself every day, it'll either lift you up or tear you down. So look for something positive in each day, even if some days you have to look a little bit harder. You know, one small positive thought in the morning can change your whole day. And I promise, every positive thought will propel you in the right direction. So whatever you do, make sure it makes you happy. And know that a positive mind towards everything will give you a happier life. That's right. And those are some motivational words. Hey, where my audience at? Where's that? Ooh, ooh, where? There it is. We are fully charged, girl. We got audiences up in here today. Yes, indeed. Again, the lines are open. You're more than welcome to call in, ask our guest a question. Give a girl a holler, a shout out. The number is 214-431-5032. We are going live right here from Globe Life Park, Fishbowl Radio Network, the Queen Silvy Show. And I want to welcome my first guest to the show. What?
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. How are you?
I'm all. Did you hear? I am super califragilistic. I am super califragilistic.
I'm gonna mess it up. All in all, you good?
So that's all good. A true queen, indeed. Born with Tetra-amelia Syndrome. She's an advocate for disability awareness, community leader, inspirational, motivational speaker, the founder of Chasing Chassidy. Showing others how to overcome shame about their differences and accept a new perspective and movement. Don't diss my ability. From Arlington, Texas, I introduce to you Queen Chassidy Young.
Well, so I wanted that extra part that the sexy is something. I need Tim, give me a sexy title.
Okay, mine wasn't good enough. Give her one, Tim.
give her.
I need a sexy title.
She like coming down right now. Gonna drop it like it's hot in studio right here for you.
Oh,
boo.
She like that. The world's sexiest comedian, world's sexiest granny.
I need one of those. The world's sexiest motivator right here.
How about the world's most inspiring, motivating girl?
I need girl, queen.
And then you're supposed to say, well, how is she inspire, motivate? That's
okay, secret. She checked me, so I'm gonna definitely give you a more hotter.
There you go. I'll get it by the end of the show. I promise.
Turn up the fair.
Well, we have a beautiful queen here. Let me tell you what I thought of you first when I very first saw you, because when I first saw you, it was the show Born Different. And I'm like, she is no different than me. You can look at me and can't tell I'm different. Right. We all are different, but I'm like, I gotta have her. So you inspired me. So I searched and searched, and wherever I was sending messages, you obviously was never getting it because it was like a month ago. And then all of a sudden, I saw you on Facebook, and girl, I shed a tear in just this left eye when I found out that you live in Arlington. I was like, snap! So I'm glad to have you here on the show.
I'm happy to be here. I am.
So what do you see when you look at me?
What do I see when I look at you?
I'm going to put you on the spot. Be honest.
When I saw you, when I came in, I said, look at her. She flies. You got your shoulders out sexy. I said that. You said you like the off the shoulder. And I said she got her sexy shoulders out.
You're right.
I said she's slim, walking like a model.
I like her. She is really doing that.
Wait, she buttering you up.
I'm telling you.
No, it's real.
Girl, I'm about to write you a check. You is straight.
Yeah. This is real. Now, if you want me to butter you up, I can do that.
Well, you know what? I thought of when I saw you. Mm-hmm. And I think of it now, even when I stood at the elevator for 20 minutes waiting for you.
Mm.
No, I didn't stand up 20 minutes. I did not. But when I saw you, I thought, this is a very beautiful, strong, independent, determined, short woman with big boobs. Hello, keeping it real.
They're not mine.
That's what I see. They are yours. You can say this ain't mine, but for 1995, yes, it is. I bought it. It's mine.
Right.
So born with a rare disorder characterized by the absence of four limbs is what they say. Uh-huh. What can you tell me about Tetra-amelia Syndrome?
You know what? I recently found out exactly the name, the diagnosis of what it's called. I didn't know what it was. People were like, what happened? I'm just born without, you know, I didn't know. So I really am learning at 32, 33 about
that's all right. Disorder. So am I learning.
So I can't really tell you much about it. I do know that it is, you know, just a disorder that causes the absence of limbs or extremities for most people. But it doesn't, you know, doesn't limit you.
It don't stop nothing. That's the name society have put to something.
Yeah,
you know.
It don't stop nothing.
They call some people crazy. And I know some crazy people, and some of them are cool.
Aren't there limitations in our mind?
Truly.
That's the label
your,
that they
your limitations lie in your mind.
Truly.
Absolutely.
Truly.
But do you mind sharing your story, starting with where you were and where you are now today?
You know, I grew up very normal. Very normal. I had, you know, my parents, they made up in their mind. My mom didn't know she was, you know, carrying me and I was missing limbs or, you know, had the disorder. And when she, you know, when the doctors brought her to me, they were scared. They thought she would be scared. They didn't want to bring her. They kept me away from her for a while to try to prepare her. And she was like, you know, bring my daughter and we're going to make it happen.
Right.
And you know, my mom and my dad, they didn't put any restrictions on me. Within my household, it was very normal. I had chores.
That's what it should be.
Me and my sisters and brothers, we fought. If I didn't do right, I got my butt burned. So it was not a it was a very normal household. You know, growing up, I knew I was different, but I didn't see a difference. But, you know, when you start to get into society, you start to feel different. So I had to just make up in my mind very early that this is you. You know, there was a moment where I was really sad and down about it. And I was like, wait a minute. I didn't attribute anything to a disability until I got to a space where I was told I couldn't do something. And I was like, because I wasn't used to that.
You talking about, I bet, are you talking about like Six Flags?
I'm talking about Six Flags. They going to hate me, child.
They going to give you some season pass tickets. What you talking?
Say, look now, stop talking about us. But it really was a defining moment for me. Yeah. And I think, you know, I'm thankful for that moment because it was a moment where I felt like I was living in this world where I didn't see this disability. Mm-hmm. And when I went to Six Flags and, you know, that day I was met with the disability in front of me. And that day I felt so different. And I felt like an outcast. But what it did, it brought me into a real world. You know, I don't ever want to live in a land where things aren't real.
Right.
And it made me understand there are some things you're not going to be able to do.
That's true.
But you've been able to do so much. You were there because you were a captain of a dance team. You were there.
Do it, girl.
You know what I mean? You were there.
You be twerking.
We weren't twerking yet.
I'm just asking because I like people with twerks. You know, I ain't even got it back there, so I just tweak.
I have a little twerk action, but not much. But it was a really, really defining time for me.
That's what's up, though.
And at that age, it made me decide, you know, are you going to move forward or are we going to just be stuck here? And now you're just this disabled girl. And that wasn't me. Inside of me, it was too much life and it was too much desire and it was too much drive and passion to live. And it was like, okay, you really didn't even want to get on this roller coaster.
You know what? That's all right. There's things that I can't do anymore, yeah. You know, but it is what it is.
Yeah, that's
there's
what it was.
A lot of things that you can do.
It is what it was. And then a couple of years later, I went in the eighth grade. We went on a trip. So Six Flags found out about it. So they were like, this time, listen, let this girl get on whenever she want to get on. She won't want no problem. So I got on the same roller coaster. I was scared out of my mind. I was like, oh, okay. So this is not something I want to do.
I'm from Ohio, so I think down here in Texas, everything. I don't like roller coasters anymore. I've experienced it, but some of these highways remind me of a roller coaster. You're going up, you're going around, you're going down.
Yeah.
It's freaking crazy. But, you know, as kids, kids are not supposed to have concerns or worries.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not a single worry in the world. Did you have any worries and concerns growing up or in school?
No. I really didn't. I had a very strong support system. And you know what? I just was blessed to be around people, not necessarily people who supported me, but because I had a presence that I'm not, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't adapting to you. You were going to adapt to me. You were going to, I was bringing the energy, you know, I wasn't being, you know, I wasn't a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
I was bringing it. So people really started, so they saw it and they were like, oh, okay. But when you started to navigate and doing things and seeing me writing and seeing me doing different things, they're like, oh, okay, she cool, you know. So people were very, you know, very supportive.
You had that look. I mean, they knew. Don't mess with her.
I had that look, and I probably had about four or five people behind me saying, really, don't mess with her. So
for me growing up, I used to be always called teacher. And they would say, you can be a teacher. And I'm like, why? Why are y'all keep calling me teacher? And they would say, because of your two pencils, you know, messing with my little stick legs, you know. But yeah, mess with it.
I like those long legs.
Sticks and stones would break your bones, you know, you messing with the wrong one. But, you know, okay, you realize a little bit of something that you went through at that point. But you come a long way since then.
a minor.
What happened? What happened or what didn't happen? Tell me how you pulled yourself. Mm-hmm. You, because right now you go around motivating others. You go around talking and motivating people of getting out of the rut or that bad feeling and having that self-love. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So how did you pull yourself out? Tell me that secret.
I was young. I was probably, 12 when I had to make the decision. And it wasn't immediately. I wasn't at Six Flags like, oh, okay. But I was sad. I cried the whole day. I cried the entire time we were at Six Flags. I cried. My sister was there. I cried the entire time. I went home and cried. Me and my family, my parents sat me down and had a real conversation with me. And just telling me, you know, just reminding me of who I am. Like, you're not finna let this Six Flags, you know, tell you who you are,
still,
what you can
do. I understand.
But you're 12.
Yeah.
And you're seeing. And that's, and then this, and I didn't understand that, because at this one time, it's me and these girls on stage together, unified. And now I'm the outcast.
You're supposed to be a part of that celebration.
I didn't feel that.
Like
exactly.
That.
So when you're 12, you don't know how to process it. But I allowed myself to feel it. Because,
well, we got
to
go through it.
We
got
to
right?
go through it. So I allowed myself to feel that because I wanted to get through that, and I didn't want that to come back. So I need to feel whatever I need to feel at that time. So I was down, but I can't naturally stay in a somber place really long. I really try not to. So we just made up in our minds, and we just gone. It just sell me to, well, if I can't do that, then let me just try whatever. Let's just try things. So I was, after that year, I started doing everything. I was in cheerleading. I was on the step team. Like,
you was on the beach. You was on the beach too, wasn't you?
Yeah, that was recently.
I know.
But I was like, I'm gonna do every single thing that I want to do, because I know what. You know, I already know what it feels like to not be able to do it. I know what this feels like. So whatever. But let's just try it. I would have rather, probably would have been more regretful not trying to do something and failing at it than doing something and realizing, oh, okay, you can do that, Chaz. You know, mm-hmm. So it took some time. I had to shake it off, but I went through the emotions of it.
Well, I'm glad you did.
Yeah. So
I'm really glad you did. Some people right now woke up today depressed, woke up today not feeling good, or just don't even love themselves. You got to start with loving yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, if you can't love yourself, how you expect somebody else to?
That's true. That's so true.
Right?
That's very true. You
and you embrace and enforce self-love, right?
I do.
So how do you practice self-love?
How do I practice self-love? I practice self-love through self-care. I take care of myself. You know, it's never about, I self-affirm. I'm very, you know, adamant for that, where I don't need someone to tell me, or I don't look for affirmations for others. Why, it's a beautiful thing, and I think that it's very important for us to have that, but to desire that and to always want that and to need validation from others, it's hard. So it's really important for me to take care of myself, to surround myself with people that are positive, people that are like-minded like myself, and, you know, to be surrounded by love.
Well, let me stop right now and give a shout out to your parents and to Ashley. And who's the other? I don't, forgive me, but help me.
So it's
Chassidy. I know you have a brother, but
I have a brother, Fred. My sister Ashley, my parents Fred and Francis, and Candace.
Okay, yeah, yes, Candace. That's who I wanted to give a shout out to, because it is so important to have somebody in your corner.
It is.
I don't care who you are, what color you are, what you're going through things. It is important to have. So you see, you might not have a big, long, skinny arm like me, but do you realize all the areas that you are blessed? We all are individually. So right now, just pretend there is a teenage girl right now who is going through some stuff. Oh, I have a caller. I'm going to tell you that in a minute.
Okay.
Let me pause and go to the lines and say welcome to the Queen Silvy Show. Okay. State your name and where you're calling from.
You have superstar King Bikini all the way from Holland, Ohio. How are you
doing today, my King, you know I'm super califragilistic. He knows. Yes, I am. Absolutely. Well, you may as well finish it, because Kane, I'm also
amazing.
Amazing. You better believe it. How you doing today, Kane? What can I do for you also? Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Kane. You're wondering, superstar Kane Patino. A guy actually called on my line and said, superstar Kane Patino, he is a superstar. He's a former guest on the Queen Silvy Show. He's okay. Born blind and autistic.
Okay.
But he's a Christian rapper.
Okay.
And he has many, I can't even explain the videos that he has and the words that he impact behind. And he memorizes every song. How many do you have out, Kane? 17 wow. songs. That's awesome. What's up, Kane. I appreciate you calling in, but listen, tell everybody where they can check out some of your videos.
Well, I have a Facebook, and you can find me under Kane, K-A-Y-N-E, Patinio, P-E-T-I-N-I-O-T. You can also follow my mother, Casey, C-A-S-E-Y, Patinio, P-E-T-I-N-I-O-T. And then I have a YouTube page, which you can go under Kane, K-A-Y-N-E, the Christian rapper.
That's what's up, Kane. Thank you very much. I appreciate you taking the time and calling in today and speaking to Miss Queen Chassidy here.
Thank
I want
Kane.
You to.
You're more than welcome.
And I want you to spread the word for the Queen Silvy Show every Tuesday from 11 to 1. Say hi to everybody back in Ohio, and you have a great, terrific Tuesday, Kane. I will. Okay, thanks. I love that word, amazing. I do. That's one of my favorite. Thank you. You have a good day, too. The lines are still open. You're more than welcome to call in and ask Queen Chassidy a question or give a shout-out. The number is 214-431-5032. We're currently going live on Facebook under Silvy Star, so you can see our beautiful celebrity guest that is here in studio. Any questions, send them in. We will gladly get them to Chassidy. So, Chassidy, self-love, in my opinion, is one of the most important aspects of overcoming anxiety. It helps build your confidence. Do you agree with me on that?
100%.
So tell others how they can go about. What steps do one take in gaining that self-love? And that's important for these youth and our teenagers who go through bullying and peer pressure.
Ideally, I don't think that self-love is one thing. So I don't think that the steps that I take for self-love are different than the steps that, you know, D's taken for self-love and the steps that you've taken, you know. I just think that essentially there is a core value part of it in acknowledging yourself, your true self, acknowledging who you are, knowing who you are. For one, you can't love something you don't know, like truly who you are.
Right.
Some people say you are, not who you think you are, but truly acknowledging your true self. And when you find that person, you find ways to show that person some self-love.
Absolutely.
But I think the first thing you do is you have to acknowledge your true self, and you find ways that you start your own journey to self-love. There's not one way. I don't think there are steps to do it, because what works for me may not work for you and may not work for the next person. But essentially, as I mentioned, to the core, self-love for me was acknowledging who I was and moving beyond the story of Chastity with the Amelia Tetra. That's not my story. That's a condition that I've born with.
Right.
That's not my story. I'm a speaker. Body positivity and self-love, that's the story. And finding that, you know, rewrote it and got me to a place where I can start to really love who I am, because it was beyond what I look like.
You have to make yourself the priority.
Exactly.
That's basically what you have to do.
Truly.
Okay, I care about that person, but I'm not going to put that person first
right.
before me.
Right.
Unless they go into the store to get me something. it's a difference
or
in the whole thing.
Unless they go into the bank, then it's different.
Yeah, you know, or they give me some money. You
that's
know,
different. That's I'll you
give you a ride.
A bit. That's a little bit.
I'm just saying.
Just for the
I
moment.
Am your friend, girl.
I am a friend in you for a moment, for lunch.
I am being so seriously silly.
I'm serious, too.
I know. So we have a beautiful queen next to you. She is a life coach by the name of Queen Devon Coleman. How are you today?
I'm good.
You are a friend of Queen Chassidy.
Yes, I am.
How did you guys meet?
Woo! Well, let's
and you started out with woo.
Well, because I'm going back to our last project, and Chaz saying she's been in the background of my life, which is crazy. But we went to the same school, but different grades. So she went to school with my brother, and we ended up connecting on Facebook, because I wanted to reach out to her in 2017. I wanted to style her. It started as a fashion thing. And then we both realized that we shared the same common interest with wanting to help people really connect with themselves, love themselves, and be better.
That's awesome.
And that's when we started creating projects and going out together. Started with our love hug project.
I saw once where you guys was out just giving out
hugs. The local news actually picked that up.
That's what's up. The world needs it.
It was incredible. We realized it was needed. You do need that type of
work. Did y'all spend the whole day doing that?
We picked the spot, and we were going to have people come up to us, but they weren't moving fast enough. We decided to get up and take our water and our notes, and we actually went to people and approached them like, "Hey, we're just here.
That's what's up, man.
We'll give you a hug, and you know, keep it."
Made their day. I'm sure. You never know who needs that.
It made our day. It was a beautiful experience. It really was to be able to get that type of connection, and just humanity was restored at that time.
That's what's up.
We restored humanity that day.
We did, and there were people that were going through lots of things, and we didn't even know.
But
made their day.
That is what's up.
Yeah. Cassidy, we have a couple of viewer questions.
Oh,
okay.
All right.
Well, let's bring it.
One person says, "That's not a question. That's more of a statement. You are a gift from God."
All right, we know. Yes,
we know this. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much. She said, "Tell me something I don't know."
Let's see here. Hang on. Do you go on dates?
Mm-mm. Oh, whoa. Who that out there wanting
that question? I was waiting on that.
That out there wanting?
She was anticipating somebody wanting to.
Do I go on dates?
Wow!
All the time, me and my sister go on dates all the time.
they want to know that whoever that is, she's right here in studio. You can come down here and get an autograph.
Oh Lord.
Well, there's a follow-up question is, do you have children or want children?
Oh, somebody is haunting, man. Dang.
I don't have any children currently. I have godchildren, but they didn't come from my body. So I don't have any children of my own. Do I want children? Yes, I do. One. I want a child.
One?
Yeah.
That's I would think up. That'd be wonderful.
Yeah. One child.
And she answered another question because somebody asked if she was attended church, believed in God.
Do I attend church and believe in God? Do I believe in God? Yes, I do. Do I attend a church? Yes, I do. Yes and yes.
Yes. Wow, I appreciate that.
When I heard her talk about God's children, she kind of answered that question from another viewer. So there we go.
Well, thank you all. Thank you very much.
Keep it on coming.
She can handle whatever you got. Bring it. Okay, because we're going to keep it real on the show. I appreciate that. But Devon, tell me about yourself and what it is that you do.
Well, what I do is I help others truly love themselves wounded, understanding their emotions, their things that they may be battling with within, just as I have, and really just connect with their inner child and love themselves. Like Chaz said, love is broad. It can be done in so many ways, but I think it's important for us to identify the things that keeps us limited. And it started with me, like, going to the root of things. And you know, my business, my coaching is detox. I mean, I'm D, but you hear detox and teas, right? I'm helping you detox your soul.
That's what's up. I like that.
That's what I do. I really push to inspire, like, people to really look at themselves for who they are.
Do they come to you, or you just happen to just walk past and see someone that's really can utilize your gift?
Oh man, it comes in so many different ways. As Chaz mentioned earlier, there's this light about you when you're glowing and feeling good, and sometimes I attract that. And some things I don't want to attract, but that's okay.
Okay,
I got boundaries. I've created boundaries for myself.
Y'all both said that at the same time, and I sure want to know, like, what? Break it down.
Go to boundaries, honey.
Like.
for me, I know, Chaz, we've talked about this a lot, but when you do have this light, and you attract. And sometimes
you get attract the wrong one. You gotta flick a few off.
The butterfly. Sometimes you check the mouse.
Right. Yeah. Sometimes you gotta just flick that flea.
Yeah. I just like to stick to what I feel is my assignment.
Yeah.
Because everything is not your assignment. You can help everybody. Because things are super heavy.
Right.
And that's okay. But for me, it's just been a matter of. Authentically connecting. And
don't it feel good though to make a difference?
It does.
And for somebody else. It really does. I can imagine what the hug did for someone who was just having a bad day. You know, it's terrible. But tell everybody how they can follow you on social media as well as contact you if they want to contact you, get some coaching.
Well,
y'all
can go to my website, www.detox, that's DeeTox, life coaching, all one word, .com. I do offer different, I have journal entries, I have positive things. I do offer a free consult if someone wants to reach out to me and find out about my coaching services. I'm on Facebook, Detox Life Coaching. I'm on Instagram, Detox
Look
Life
at
Coaching.
Look at you.
I have a podcast. It's also on Google Play, Apple Podcasts, and Spotify.
What's the name of it?
And it's called Detoxing with Coach D.
I like that, girl. Detoxing with Coach D. That got a fling on there.
Yeah. Deep. It's deep.
That is.
Because it's a deep dive.
So is Chasing Chassidy.
Very much so.
Tell me about it.
You know what, Chase and Chastity started, it was actually a documentary that I did prior to Born Different. It was maybe, it was before I met you, it was 2016, 2015. We did a documentary, we had a young lady come. I started, background to the story, I was at the nail salon because I self-care, so
right.
I keep my toes taken care of, my hair taken care of, you know, I might have a beat down every now and then. A beat down is a face, not a physical beat down, you guys. Makeup.
Who do you hire?
Let me correct, they're going to make that love, what, you getting beat up?
I'm like, dang, she pay somebody to punch her. No, she don't. She does
no,
not.
I'm not getting, don't start no rumors. No. I'm getting beat on. Nobody's beating on me. Just the makeup brushes and the makeup.
That's a term. That's a term. Right.
But I take pride in physical appearance. For me, I just like to look good. I like to dress nice.
It's important for us important to feel
as
good.
As a woman.
To look, yes.
You know,
I understand.
I'm a woman first. So we were at the nail salon, and there was a lady there. And she just kept turning her chair around, staring. So I'm seeing her. I'm like, lady, say something. Speak something. Like, what you looking at? But something didn't. I wasn't never like a, dang, what you looking at type of person. I always will smile. Now, if you don't smile back, then it's just a problem.
Right.
But if I see you looking, I'll smile. So I kept smiling at her, but this like three smiles in. I'm like, I don't have another smile for you. What is it? So she was done doing what she was doing, and she came up to me and sat down, and she was like, you know, I'm just watching you, and, you know, I'm just inspired by how you're just in here. You're taking care of yourself. I think I just got my hair done, so I'm just looking real dainty. So she said, have you ever thought about a documentary? And I was like, I've thought about it, but I've never done it. She called her daughter up and was like, I need you to come. This is girl. I want you to do a documentary on. Her daughter pulled up. And she looked, she was like, yep, let's do it. So
that's
she
right.
followed us around for probably 3-4 months.
Really?
We was with, her name was Fatima. We was with Fatima so long, but she really, she got a lot of footage. And so she struggled, like, what do I call this? But she was like, I'm chasing you around because you're doing everything. You're moving around. We're traveling. You at the mall. You're out of town. You're on flights. You're at work. So I'm just chasing you. And we were like, oh, Chasing Chastity.
That friend
worked
out
great.
We were
on the go. She was, I wasn't expecting to you to be on the go so much and just doing so much and being so involved. And that's what Chasing Chastity is about. You know, just being, you know, multiple things. Like I always say, it's never a story about a disability. That's
right.
That's not even a part.
Get over it.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, no arms. Boom. Next thing.
Right.
So, you know, Chasing Chastity is about body positivity, about self-love, It's about fashion. It's about love, relationships, healing. So it's so many other things, and it's not just boxed.
Right.
We're on the go. Yeah.
Where can others check it out?
You can definitely check in Chase and Chassidy. I have my Facebook page. I have a personal Facebook, but you can definitely follow me on Chase and Chassidy. I check that as well. I check my messages there too. You can my YouTube channel, Chase and Chassidy, as well. And you can email me with any type of, you know, if you want.
You hurried up and said, yes, you can catch me on my, not my personal. Not my don't listen. Trying to hit, no, don't do that.
Listen, I'm trying to tell you, when Born Different, the show first came on.
You were getting hit up left going 40.
Oh, my gosh. It was like an all night thing. And most of the messages were just like, you know, you're inspiring. I just love your attitude. Da, 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 da. So it'd be like 10 of those. And then it'd be like, boom. Let's get married. You know, 10 of those. Boom, let's have a baby. I'm like, wait, what?
You shouldn't be so hot. Okay? If you weren't that hot, you're like, bringing them all out the woodworks and things. Like,
I wasn't even trying to be hot.
Well, if you got it, you got it. Come on now. Right. Just be your authentic self. If you got it, you got it. So there it is. But there is a chronicle. Was it Self-Love Chronicles 2.0?
Yes.
So tell me about that. And there's another one, right? Or is it just the one?
Before. Mm-hmm. That was the first one.
Was it Self-Love also? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That was the first one that she did with the first girl.
Fatima. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she came. That's when me and Dee we first kind of connected after we did the, she styled me. That's who she reached out and styled me. And we just connected on that level, just having the same type of energy and really the same type of inspiration and mm-hmm. goals mm-hmm. and essentially just people who genuinely love people and to people who love themselves yeah. and know what it feels like to love yourself and you want people to feel that like mm-hmm. I've talked to a girl after the documentary. She messaged me and I got some really deep things about she messaged me and she was just like, I've been watching your story. And she was just talking about how she's attempted suicide mm-hmm. and she was very suicidal. And she said, I came across Instagram and I saw you and I watched your story. I back to back about 10 times. She was like, mm-hmm. I need you to please don't give up because if you give up, I don't know what I'm going to do. Mm. So I was like, you know, you start, it's, I don't take it light.
People well, looking up to you already.
We don't take self-love. We take that seriously.
Very much so.
Because people see that. And they can find in themselves like, okay, if she can love herself, I can love myself. Mm-hmm. And that was the same type of, you know, energy that
the world needs so much more of you two, straight up.
Yeah. So we connected and we did the first video, self-love, and we broke it up into different parts. And then recently we was like, you know, let's do it again. Let's and that's it. Where 2.0 came.
Keep doing it. Yeah. You know, you're impacting people, believe it or not. And then not just the young, the mm-hmm. young adults, because it's never too late to love yourself. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people here, young and old, that's lost out here in the world. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it can just be hearing what you have to say
yeah.
that helps spark that. And even an old folks, I'm just...
it's amazing you said that.
Even in old folks,
messages all the time, and most of them are older,
right?
Yeah,
people,
right?
And I'm like, whoa! It's like, wow,
right?
This is bigger than us.
Yes, it is.
Much bigger.
It is much bigger. And Miss Hot Thing over there, you know, when you're not busy, you know, working and telling these dudes and everybody what to do, what's some things you enjoy doing?
I don't tell dudes anything. I'm dating. I enjoy personal time. I enjoy time with my family. Mm-hmm. I enjoy being around people who love me and people who I love. I truly enjoy, you know, these type of settings mm-hmm. where you're able to be around people and you're able to share and just be real about life. Mm-hmm. But for the most part, I'm a homebody. Like,
okay, movies. What's a good movie for you?
A good movie for me, I like scary movies.
Ooh, I do too, girl.
So,
have you seen I Spit on Your Grave?
That's a scary movie.
Oh, girl.
Like a scary movie?
Like it ain't no joke. It was so good they did an I Spit on Your Grave too. Girl, if you can handle that movie.
Where you see that?
I can't tell you no more.
You can't tell me nothing.
It's called
Netflix.
It's called I Spit on Your Grave.
I Spit on Your Grave.
It ain't no joke. But yeah, I like scary movies too.
I love scary movies. So I'll sit up and watch a good scary movie. I like to read. But when I'm home, you know, just kind of
practice. I know you like Frankie, Beverly, and Mace.
I do.
I tried to get them on, but
I'm trying to, girl. When you do?
Yeah. I've been trying. When I found out you liked it, Mace and Frankie and Beverly, I was trying straight up. But I want you to give a message. Because when you finally see Ellen and Oprah ass, you tell them that you was on the Queen Silvy Show first.
You got it. I will.
I will.
They're taking too long. I said I need to go to them because they're taking too long to come to me.
That's right.
Those are studios right now.
So. Yeah, I know they closed down, but they
they're at home. Today's technology make it that you can even do it from home. She can call you from her expensive toilet.
She sure can. So
and talk and do, because that's how I be trying to get some of them celebrities. When y'all at home and not on tour on a Tuesday, come on.
I know that's right. So that's, yes, I love them. I definitely sit at home and listen to music all day very loudly.
Is there a music artist you just can't stand? You like, ooh, if they play him one or her one more time.
I don't listen to like the radio. So neither do I. Any music I'm listening to is I love the music.
Yeah. So. I listen to the up and coming. I listen to what the radio don't play. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? That's why this platform is here for even those artists who don't get that play from the radio, but they mm-hmm. got it going on just as much as Beyonce or Jay-Z. Hello.
Yeah. I don't listen to, I find myself listening to a lot of old school stuff. I was like, oh my gosh, am I really getting old?
If you call yourself old, girl, I am sitting here just as ancient as it want to be. That's terrible. But you ain't never seen a sexy ancient like this, though.
Not a now, no. What? Sexy one like you before.
No, I'm just saying. So, you like music.
I love music.
You have sound and beat. Put your foot in your mouth now, because we finna do something right now together.
I'm not scared.
Where all of us is going to come together right now. It's called Sound Creation.
Okay. Sound Creation.
I'm going to do it twice because I'm going to start it out. And then the second time, you going to start it out. And this is how you do it. You do a tone, a beat, a melody, or something. And then I'm going to keep doing it. Then you're going to join in. Then you're going to join in. And Smooth's going to join in. And together, we're going to create our own sound. Don't look at me like that, because I'm so confused.
Listen.
Okay. So we following her group.
No, yeah, whatever beat I do, you just create and make up your own beat or tune. Or if you want to throw some words, you can throw words. Mm. But the point is you're going to create it yourself. Now, it's going to be a CD coming out this summer, because I have Olympic players. I have Grammy winners. They all participate and do this. And no sound is ever the same. So that's the creativity part of it. We're going to create it right now. Now, I don't really beatbox or do anything, but... You want me to go slower? Hold up. Ashley is laughing. I saw that. I saw that. You're out of my sidebar. I was like, hold up.
I'm looking at her eyes. I'm just like, I tried to look at her so I wouldn't laugh.
I know. I don't want to laugh. I saw her.
So I said, well, I'll just find. I'll just look at
her. I'm like, wait a minute. Why you got to be here?
So I just look outside. Because she's horrible.
It is not as bad as you think, Ashley. Trust me, okay?
I think that we did a wonderful job. I thought we was going to do like a melody.
You can throw it down something. Because hit it. Hit it. I'm going to follow whatever you do, Chassidy.
I'm going to follow you. I just did it. Pick a song. We're going to sing it.
What song? We're going to sing it. You better bring some water in here, because the only time I sing is in the shower. Hello, where's the water?
Imagine this is a shower. Nice big
okay,
shower.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
What song we gonna sing?
What song you wanna sing?
I don't even know. That's what I thought we was doing. Well, Smooth Tim.
Sing.
We need a song.
You know what? I don't know a song. I can only do beats. Hit it.
You can only do beats? Okay.
I can only make sounds like... You know, I don't... but I'm serious.
It's gonna completely mess up our CD that we put out with beats. We got... about an hour and a half worth of beats.
Oh, see, somebody needs to rap over those beats.
You know what? You brought up singing in the song thing, and I'm thinking you got something right on the tip of your tongue. You about to blaze. You like singing?
I thought that's what we were doing.
Sound creation is sound.
Sound.
Singing is sound. So sing. Blow for me.
What's a song we can sing?
What do you like singing?
I told you I'm a Frankie Beverly fan. So I sing a lot of Frankie Mays.
Break it down.
I sing a lot of songs that make you feel good. What's my favorite Mays song? What's something we can... We Are One.
We Are One was a song. Yep. We didn't get that, did we?
We didn't get that.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, that's one of my favorite.
Yeah, I can't sing that one, too. We Are One. Yeah, I can do the
beat. You gonna do the beat?
Yeah, we are one. Yeah, but I don't even know that. But okay, you just blew it. Thank you for trying to get me to sing when you know I can't sing.
I thought you was gonna sing with me.
And she got out of sound creation real good.
She slid out of that and then tried to wheel you into it. Go ahead, Queen. Warm up the pipes and sing for us.
That was real cute with that on how she got out of sound creation.
That was pretty slick, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Chassidy, is there anything else that you want to add? Any upcoming events or anything that you want to share?
I am working on an event in May. It will be a self-love positivity brunch style. I'm working with another young lady in Dallas by the name of Kashmir, who's super efficient with her feet. She was born with the same similar condition. She's born without arms, but she uses her resources very well. And we connected very recently, and so she and I are working on a self-love style brunch in May. So the details for that will be available on Chase and Chassidy. So please go follow the page. So I will post that information and anything upcoming that I am doing. Hopefully, everyone's not sick anymore by that time.
Right? It's getting crazy out here.
It is getting crazy, but I do want to encourage people to stay calm and to not panic. When you're panicking, you are not using your best judgment.
Right.
And you're not thinking. And I think that a lot of people are doing that. I think it's very important for us to move forward together. So Absolutely. Don't buy all the tissue, guys. Mm-hmm. And I got a problem.
That's right.
Because everybody bought the tissue, but it's a lot of soap left. It's a lot of soap left.
Okay. Yeah.
So, say what I want to say.
Yeah.
Right? I ain't even gonna go there.
Yeah, you don't want me to go and show you pictures. I went to look and see. Now, why is it so much of this and they getting all that?
I was just wasn't understanding because in my mind I figured using our tissue for a certain reason. But y'all left the soap.
But they causing all of this panic that's just really not nonsense. I mean, whatever happened to West Niles and all these other things?
Zika.
Yeah.
And there were just historically, there's always been, you know, viruses in play.
Yeah.
And that's just natural in humanity in the world and just things moving. And I think that it's important to understand that we'll get through it. Mm-hmm. Of course, use your wisdom.
Right.
But for sure, be knowledgeable.
Well, we should always practice these precautionary
methods. Every day.
Thank you very much.
To be with West Nile, Zika, or the coronavirus.
Wash your hands.
Keep your fingers out your mouth.
Yeah.
That's true. But since we've moved down in Texas, I've noticed that Texans, most, if it's raining, they drive crazy. They always hitting them brakes, but then they go to the store and clean up too. They think, what was that? When it's raining bad, like they're supposed to say it's supposed to rain real rough, they go and clean out the stores like something's going to happen. And that is so funny to me as an Ohioan. That why they do that. But it is what it is.
It is what it is. But
tell everybody again, Detox.
Coach D.
Coach D, tell everybody again how you can be followed on social media.
Oh, you guys can find me on Facebook. My podcast, Detoxing with Coach D. Instagram, Detox Life Coaching. Yeah. If you see Chaz.
Yes.
Somewhere
you're
definitely
pretty much
going to
see
you. Your weirdos.
And I probably get yours. We probably stop tagging each other. We sending weirdos.
We gotta stop doing it. You get it all the time. One guy was like,
"Yes,
can you hook me up with your friend?"
Oh,
no.
Oh, Lord.
So Devon's in Arlington tonight, too?
In Dallas. I'm originally from Fort Worth, but I'm in Dallas. I live in Dallas, yes.
Okay.
She just bypassed Arlington altogether. Just went right past that.
That's all right. Well, listen, I appreciate you taking the time and being on the show today. Maybe next time you can show me a dance move or something.
I can show
I don't need I seat dance.
Chair.
I'm gonna just keep it real. I can sit in the seat and do all this, and you can think that I'm like I ain't did nothing.
Seat, I'm dancing. I like to, you know, I like she to does. Chill because I don't want to sweat my makeup.
Right. That's why, girl. Wherever I go, some kind of fan is near me. Hello. But yes, I thank you so much. I want you to keep me posted on anything that you're doing because I would love to share it out there. It's the same with you, chef. I mean.
You think about food.
I am thinking about food because when I know that I'm going to go out and eat, I don't eat breakfast. I wait because then I'm going out and smash.
I know that's right.
So that's how I do that. I just get up and have a cup of tea. And then I'm waiting to go and eat. But listen, before you go, let's do some birthdays because my theory is that if you woke up today, it's your birthday. But it is officially some birthdays today, like Tamar Braxton. Her birthday is today. How old do you think she is?
40.
You think? How old?
42.
Girl, it's on at 42. Did you tell her that, Ashley?
That's crazy.
She's older than 42?
She's 42.
Yeah,
she's 42.
Wow, I didn't.
That's my instinct.
Okay, so everybody know Ice-T, right?
Mm-hmm.
His wife, Coco.
Mm-hmm.
Her birthday is today. How old do you think she is?
52.
Ooh,
Coco.
You said 48? Ooh.
I'm being
54. She is going to be mad at you because she got money and they pay for their little stuff. She is 40.
She's just 40?
Y'all, you girls are horrible. She just 40?
She just had a baby like not too long ago,
so
you know.
Like they've been around so long. Yeah, that, maybe that's what it is.
Y'all are terrible.
Yeah, she was an actress and a model. She was like, what? I thought she was an old.
I thought she was like 100.
Well, his wife is younger
and
than
she,
him.
She must be much younger than him then.
Yeah.
He's definitely over 40.
Yeah. Well, you know, he.
Wonder why it was all dusty when she walked by
her. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He found her in a club somewhere. She's a model and an actress, but.
After he dusted her off.
Right. So, do you know the actor Rob Lowe?
Rob Lowe, yes.
62.
He's over 50. How old?
62.
53?
He's like
57. 62. He's 55. Close. You way off, Tim. Way, way off.
How can I be off by. I was off by 7 years. How am I way off?
That's enough.
That's enough. Okay, I missed.
The last one, we all know the Kardashians, but do you know the brother of the Kardashians, Rob Kardashian? Today is his birthday.
Oh, really? 32.
And he's a weird one.
Chassidy is so hot. I'm telling you, she is on it. He is 32.
Come on.
Well, for everyone whose birthday it is today, Smooth, hit it.
What do you want me to do about it?
I want you to hit it.
No. I refuse to hit it. Now that you're trying to get us to sing again?
I don't sing, I tell you.
Happy birthday.
There you go.
Happy birthday to you.
There you go.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah, there you go. I knew
happy
I could get her to sing.
Pisces season. Season.
Alrighty. Okay, fine. Hang on.
I still didn't hear it.
Whatever.
It's cool. Chassidy sung happy birthday to everyone whose birthday it is today.
I got it.
Thank you very much.
Is the messages in, Tim? Are the messages up?
Oh, yes.
All right. Well, let me pause and get those messages in because those are important messages that must be heard. And when we get back, we have Donna Sellers of Unique Catering and Party Planning here on the Queen Silvy Show. I thank you all. You're welcome to stay.
Thank you. Because
you're going to eat, right? So you're welcome to join us if you'd like.
Okay, thanks, Queen.
But yes, let's get these breaks on right now. And when we come back, we'll have Donna Sellers of Unique Catering and Party Planning right here on the Queen Silvy Show.
What's up, it's your girl Nina Jules, the host with the most on Bump It Radio. Make sure you guys tune in every Sunday from 5 to 7 p.m. I'll have live interviews with artists and live DJs in the mix. Click on to FBRN.us or download the TuneIn Radio app and listen from anywhere. Jump into Bump It Radio on Fishbowl Radio Network every Sunday from 5 to 7 p.m. Yeah.
I'm Dr. LaSana.
Lasagna Ivory, and I am running for Duncanville ISD School Board Place 4. I have been an educator for more than 20 years. The value I place on education is demonstrated in my personal academic accomplishments, my relationships with students, parents, teachers, and other stakeholders. As a member of Duncanville ISD School Board, I will unapologetically focus on academic achievement. Vote for Dr. Lasagna Ivory for Duncanville ISD School Board Place 4, Election Day, May 2nd, 2020, and early voting begins April 20th. I'm not just passionate, I'm prepared. I'm Lasagna Ivory, and I approve this message.
With my tail in the air. Stray cat strut, I'm a
thief's cat.
I'm a feeling Casanova.
Hey, bend that side.
Get a shoe thrown at me from a mean old man. Get my dinner from a garbage can. Got cat
Susan with Joya here to share how CBD can benefit you. Join me for a conversation on the how to and why of CBD. Did you know 80 to 90% of women are curious about CBD but have never used it? Are you suffering from fatigue, pain, lack of sleep, stress, or anxiety, just to name a few? Go to my website for more information, joya.life/joyfulsusan. That's joya.life/joyfulsusan. Or find me on Facebook, The Ultimate Transformation to Your Health and Wellness with Joyful Susan.
Have you been struggling with losing weight? Has dieting and exercising produced little or no results? Are you looking for a different approach with a history of tremendous success that has helped thousands of people not only lose the weight they deserve, but get healthy and feel great?
Tammy Stewart, certified health coach and president of Health for a Purpose, will explain why you may be struggling to lose those unwanted pounds. She'll also explain why your blood tests can show normal metabolic and thyroid numbers, yet you still have many of the symptoms of an underactive thyroid, such as weight gain, chronic fatigue, digestive issues, thinning hair, depression, trouble concentrating, and many, many more.
You deserve a new approach to health that'll focus on getting your body healthy. Get real answers at her next free seminar. Contact Tammy Stewart at www.getyourhealthbacknow.com for additional information and upcoming seminars.
Hey, this is Rocky Atlas, the last official lead guitarist with John Mayall and the Blues Breakers, here to say you are listening to the Queen Silvy Radio Show. Keep rocking the blues.
The Queen Silvy Show.
Yes, we are on the Queen Silvy Show. Thank you all for tuning in. We are currently going live on Facebook under Silvy Starks. If you want to log on and see our beautiful guest that is here in studio, spread the word. We are live on FBRN.us. I thank you for tuning in today. We have been, the first half of the show has just been amazing. I have enjoyed my conversation with Queen Chassidy of Chasing Chassidy. I enjoyed my conversation with the life coach, Devon Coleman, here. I'm not going to say that I enjoyed my sound creation because, well, Chassidy put me on the spot here with that singing, and I'm like, but I don't sing. But she pulled through for us and sung happy birthday to everyone who has a birthday there today. So I appreciate that. The lines are open if you want to call in and ask our guest a question. Chassidy is still here as well. The number to do it on is 214-431-5032. We're going to get things moving. My next guest, I want to thank you for being here on the Queen Silvy Show.
My pleasure.
I got to put my glasses on. I'm blinder than a... Providing great food service, quality service for 20 years. For all your life celebrated moments, look no further. She is a food consultant, an event party planner, founder and owner of the award-winning Unique Catering and Party Planning from Arlington, Texas. Everyone, I introduce to you Donna Sellers. Donna, I forgot to tell you, we have an audience here. Okay. And therefore, so, yeah. What's up? So, Donna, catering is one of the most critical parts of someone's event, and you are the one in the middle of it, right? For 20 years. I know that you have done some work in the corporate industry before getting into the catering, but how did you get into the catering?
Oh, geez. My husband and I were the ones that always did the parties, cooked at church, and I worked in corporate America for a while. When our youngest one was about 3 or 4, I decided I didn't want to do that anymore. And a cousin of mine said, you ought to open a catering business. So I got certifications and started working on menus and recipes. And
well, you know, some people might not know this, but, you know, they think that the most important part about a catering is the darn meat. What kind of meat am I getting for the catering? But it's more to that. What are the things that are involved with unique catering and party planning?
Oh, gosh. It's a lot more detailed. People think,
yeah,
well, you're bringing, just bring them the food. But you've got to plan out the menu. You've got to coordinate with the different venues, with the different vendors that people hire, whether it's for a wedding or a corporate event or a private party at somebody's house. Or a dinner party, there's so many entities that are not just the food that you bring in.
Right. Are you on premise or off premise, or you do both? What?
Most places are, you cannot cook on premise. So we bring things already prepared, keep them warm in either warmers or chafers that get set out on a buffet table.
You got your hands full.
I love it.
20 years of doing that, you. I think you either love that or you're making some darn good money.
You know, we have been told that we could do more marketing, bigger marketing, and be larger than we are. But I don't think that bigger is always better. I love people. And when you get to a certain point with catering or any kind of, you know, business that you're in, you can't deal with the individuals. That's part of what I love. I love people.
Dealing with people?
Yes.
What's the worst? It's of 20 years. I know you done had some times where you'd be like wanting to bust somebody up.
You know, we've catered over 750 weddings. I quit counting after that. We've only had 2 weddings where we had issues. Feel really blessed. But I was brought up to believe that if you treat people with respect, they treat you with respect.
Absolutely.
And I think that's a big part of it.
Well, tell me, give me some details. What issues did those 2 weddings have?
One of them decided that they changed their menu like a week before. So we made the changes, made the corrections, and then they got upset because they didn't remember changing.
Oh, my goodness.
And thought we should have had... This isn't what we have.
Yeah, they were nervous, like, what? Yes.
And then another one really was their anniversary, because when they got married, they really didn't have money to do a wedding. So for their 15th anniversary, they went all out. And it was really fun working with them. But the day of the event, they realized they had overspent. They weren't going to be able to have money to go on a vacation. So they tried to get money back from the venue, from the photographer, from us saying that things weren't done the way they we're supposed to be.
You do have your clients sign a contract.
Oh, yes. Right? They sign a contract saying what they're providing, you know, taking care of the different venues, the vendors that they hire, and we put out, you know, what we're going to do, the type of food, the hours we're going to be there, our commitment to what they need.
Do I get my money back? Do I get half my money back or anything if I'm, like, not satisfied? Is there a clause in there?
We had one that part of it was the issue with the venue. When we went to check out the venue, because we had never been there before, they had warmers. They had things there for us to keep the food warm. When we got there, they had been broken. They didn't get replaced. So we really felt that we didn't do justice to these people. So we did give them back part of their money.
So you're fair.
It was the only fair thing to do.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You're fair, and that's a good thing, because I'm going to tell you, there's some out there that's like, too bad.
So sad.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, right now, like with one of the venues in the Metroplex, they have four different venues. They took people's money. They guaranteed that they were going to have their event there, and then they closed the doors. One of my brides had booked that venue. So now she's looking.
I remember seeing that.
Now she's looking.
A lot of people were out on that.
Now she's looking for a new venue for her wedding day, which is really sad.
Well, yeah. She needs to be focused on a lot of other things than to be stressed out on that right there. Over 20 years of service, you are an award winner.
We try. We try real
hard. Tell me the award that I've seen that you've had.
We've had, you know, some awards from some of the wedding marketing places.
You're doing something right?
Yeah, and like I said, being smaller, we're able to give more attention to our clients, be it brides or corporate. We do a lot with nonprofits. We give a discount to nonprofits. And if the nonprofit is doing a fundraiser, we give them an additional discount so they can keep more of their money. I'm finding out more and more over the years that we're one of the few caterers in the area that gives a discount to the military, police, and firemen.
Look at you, girl.
Because you got
that is
back
so
to your
great.
Community.
Well, that's great. You don't find very many that give back to the community. You were out of studio when we were talking to these two beautiful queens here who are doing extraordinary, positive things and uplifting the self love and the image. You believe in self love?
Oh, definitely.
What do you do to keep yourself, you know, feeling like the woman that you are and giving yourself that self-love? Tell me a secret. What do you do?
I have a marvelous family. Last year, my husband and I celebrated 50 years.
Congrats, girl. What?
And we have three beautiful daughters, two wonderful son-in-laws, seven absolutely awesome grandchildren.
Go ahead.
One terrific great-grandchild.
You don't look
so
it.
So family is very important.
Wow.
That's what, if I'm down, I call any of my daughters and they just lift me up. My husband's terrific.
That's a blessing.
It is a blessing.
That is such a wonderful blessing. Wow, that's unique. But now you're busy. You just gave me a whole list of telling me that you sleep on the toilet. Because you said grandkids, husband, more than 50 years. I'm like, where you hide out when you want to be like, leave me alone.
I go get my nails done.
There you go. That's that self-love. That's what you're supposed to do. Take that time for yourself. I'm glad of that. How do you prioritize time then?
Oh, gosh. Family is real important. I used to take calls from clients like almost 24/7, and you realize you can't do that. You have to take some time for you, and so now we have more specific hours that we take phone calls. Mm-hmm. Although we try to accommodate clients when they're coming in from out of town or something like that for a tasting, so we try hard to put it in, you know, perspective.
Unique catering and party planning, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
What type of parties have you done?
Oh, gosh. We do family reunions. We just did a party for a dinner party for British International, British Telecom. There's a variety of things that we do. We customize to fit our clients, though, which I think is unique in itself.
So if I have a house party, would you come and cater and cook for me?
Yes, ma'am.
I really don't cook either anymore. I used to cook during when I had children, you know, the all that. But mama, then once they got grown and once I retired, I'm sorry, he will do the cooking now or the restaurant will do the cooking. I've decided that I don't want to. What I've done is I've changed how I eat now.
Right.
So to me, my healthy eating is not his way of eating. So you're on your own. You got to cook your own food. But you be throwing down. What's your favorite dish that you like to pitch? Oh, what's one of your favorites, I'll say?
Gosh. I'm a pasta person. Lasagna is probably one of my favorites.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up with grandparents that were from Syria and Lebanon. Learned how to cook all Middle Eastern food. When my husband and I got, and my mom's best friend growing up was Italian, so learned how to cook a lot of Italian food. My husband's from South Louisiana. My mother-in-law was the most
awesome your blood, I
Asian
think.
Cook ever. So I cook all kinds of food, but lasagna is probably one of my favorites.
Okay, so but at the age of 14, though, you used to cook Sunday dinners.
I cooked Sunday
think
dinners.
I don't know.
Yep.
What was something you tried to cook at 14?
Oh, gosh. Probably the first thing I think I remember cooking was trying to bake chicken.
You bless know, your heart.
Poor, and my poor mother, bless her heart, the kitchen was a mess. Because when you first
from trying to cook chicken,
yeah,
Lord.
You know, and side dishes. And so my mom was really amazing in letting me get into the kitchen and mess up everything.
Well, that's how you learn, right?
Clean it up.
Yep. That's how you learn.
Yep.
Let me pause for just one moment and go to the lines and say, welcome to the Queen Silvy Show. State your name and where you're calling from.
Hi, my name is Amelia Dowse, and I'm calling from Fort Worth, Texas.
Hey, Amelia, how are you?
Hey, Queen, I'm great. How about yourself?
You know what I'm going to say.
I do, but I still want to hear it.
I'm supercalifragilistic. Yeah, I am, girl. I am supercalifragilistic. What can I do for you today? We're having a conversation with Donna Sellers of Unique Catering and Party Planning. And I also have my beautiful queen here, Queen Chassidy, and Devon, who is here.
Well, hello, Chassidy and Miss Sellers and Devon. Hey, Smooth Tim, because I know he's there as well.
Hey.
All right. I have a question for Miss Sellers, if that's okay.
Sure.
With your party planning and events and things like that, being an entrepreneur, and would you consider yourself to be what we refer to as a mom and pop company?
Yes, most definitely.
Okay. Now, with the coronavirus pandemic going on right now, how does that affect your business per se, and are there any provisions that you've put in place to safeguard your business as a whole? I know that there may be revenue loss and things of that nature, but what are some things that you've done or that you would recommend for small business owners in that field to help us?
Well, one of the things that we have always done, be it with this pandemic or anything else, is I'm very concerned about cleanliness. When we serve, whether we've had caterers that we know that serve and they use tongs or spoons, we always wear gloves. Washing things down, keeping things clean is always been paramount to me,
mm-hmm,
whether we have this pandemic or not. I keep extra gloves and things of that nature in a catering kit in the back of my truck, so if we forget something,
that's
we still
good.
Have it.
Got that
it's
backup.
Just, yeah, we got to have backup.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's a big thing is the hand washing, the gloves for preparing things, making sure your surfaces are clean. That's a big deal. It's a big deal now, but to me, it's always been a big deal.
Great question. Thank you, Amelia.
I like it.
What about when it comes to the interaction with clients that you already have and then quite possibly potential clients, because sometimes you have to have tastings. If it's an event, then there's the viewing and things of that nature. You never really know someone else's situation because it hasn't been disclosed.
Mm.
But is there that fear, or are there any precautions in that area as well? Because, again, we never know who's infected, but you still have.
Oh. Looks like she got cut off.
But you still.
But you know where she was going.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it's this time of the year we're usually pretty slow. This is the time of the year that we go through and reclean everything, the chafers, the utensils, and everything else. When we do a tasting, I'm very careful there again with how we prepare things, how we talk with people. They can see that I'm wearing gloves when I'm serving it to them. We've really never had any issue. We have a liability policy if we ever run into something like that, but thank you, Lord, we've never run into somebody getting sick because we're very careful, and I think that's just something that needs to be done no matter, you know, what time of the year or where you are.
Isn't it you maintain temperatures, you maintain cleanliness, you're going
to
be fine.
Yeah, we did we're not big on bridal shows, but we did a small bridal show, and there were several caterers that they wouldn't let open their booths until the food got to a temperature. You have to maintain a certain degree of cold and a certain degree of hot. And if not, and it's because of bacteria that builds up.
Right.
It really is.
And we get concerned about that, so I'm glad you pay attention.
Oh, yeah. Right. You need to. You have to have that temperature, you know, for the heating and for the cold. If we do something that's cold, we always put the underneath part on ice so that you can maintain that temperature because you need to. That's
really important. She's not on the line anymore. Then,
nope. I don't know
that's
why.
That's really great to hear. Tell me about your staff. How many staffs do you have?
We have 9 staff. They technically don't have to have a food handlers because it's the contract labor, but I make sure that everybody has their food handlers. I have a managers. My front house manager has a manager's certification. We have 3 TABC certified bartenders on staff.
Oh, so you have your own bartenders.
Yes, we have bartenders on
staff.
That's
good to know.
And everybody really follows.
She look at me like that because I said the word bartender. No, I'm not an alcoholic.
It's good to have certified bartenders when you're doing catering.
Right.
Sometimes people want both.
Right.
We're a preferred vendor for 4 different venues in the Metroplex, which means they've checked us out and decided that they want to recommend us to their clients. So we feel blessed.
Right.
We feel blessed.
You should feel blessed because you're doing a lot of great things. And you're hitting on a lot of points that are very important to a lot of people when they go get a catering company for their party or for their special event or something. What's the largest number that you've had to, like, get in the kitchen and prepare for?
We did a picnic for Children's Medical Center in Dallas about 4 years ago, and it was for 450 people.
Mm.
We barbecued hamburgers and hot dogs. Plus, they had pasta salad and chips and soft drinks. And that's the largest. That's not our comfort zone. Our comfort zone is 150 to 250.
Oh, wait a minute. She's sending in something. She got cut off, but she sent me a message. Ask for me, please. When there is actual human interaction for business purposes, are there any precautions you take considering any health condition or concerns aren't necessarily disclosed? Then she goes, do you feel small businesses similar to yours will be able to thrive and survive this pandemic?
The same thing, you know, we talked about just a little while ago with the health issues and cleanliness and gloves when serving. If somebody tells me they have a particular allergy or, you know, to whether it's seafood or nuts or somebody needs to have gluten-free, we take that into consideration when we're putting menus together for them so that when they come to do a tasting, they're not going to get sick at the tasting. They're not going to be upset with something that I'm serving them that they can't taste. So, you know, we try real hard to make sure when we talk to people that we get that kind of information.
So you're the main cook or the only cook?
I'm the only cook.
Really?
Yes.
You do all that prep cooking. They prep. Do you have preppers?
I have, I have one or two that will come help.
Wow, you really love cooking.
Well, it's consistency, and that's a big part of it. You know, when things are consistent, people will refer you because they've had your food, and they know that when they refer you to somebody, it's going to be the same quality mm-hmm. that they were served.
You ever been asked to prepare a meal that you were like, what is that?
Yes.
We had like a
couple,
what?
We had a couple several years ago. They were sweethearts. And his family was originally, I can't remember what part of Africa, but he wanted oxtail stew. I'd never cooked it, never heard of it. Veronica was not going to have it, but I prepared it for their tasting.
You did it?
I looked up online, got a recipe.
I've heard of oxtail soup. I've never ate oxtail soup.
He just absolutely loved it, and she said, we're not having this at her wedding, but I let him take the rest of it home with him. So.
Have you ever, Devon, had oxtail soup? I know you've heard of oxtail soup.
Yeah, I've never had it.
I haven't either.
Chassidy. Seen him eat it, but never had it.
No, I have not. Let me
they
tell
have
you.
It that one place
I
up in Dallas where
no
they were
oxtail.
Sucking on that. Yeah, that was. No.
You are so. No. I don't. Have you ever ate chitlins?
Yeah.
I don't eat that either.
Yeah.
You eating chitlins?
My husband's grandmother used to make them.
Oh, God.
Mm-mm, I can't do it.
I ate them once or twice, and it's like they were really greasy, too, so it's not.
They're just not good.
Yeah.
No. They're just not good.
Now, I'm not grossing out anybody that eats chitlins or oxtail soup. No, I'm not. I'm only simply saying there's a variety.
It's an acquired taste,
food,
maybe.
Of food right. out Definitely here. And some people look at me and they think, oh, this chocolate cutie eats all soul food. But you know what? I've been married 3-4 times, and that's pretty much why, because I got tired of cooking soul food. Some of it will kill you. Now, I'm keeping it real. You know, today's health, the way things are, you got to take care of yourself. Sometimes it matters what you put in you.
That's true, too.
Sometimes it all the time matters what you put in you. So, you know, I just wanted to know, did you ever cook chitlins? And
I've never cooked them. We do customize our menus to fit our clients.
Okay.
I've had, we cook a variety from Middle Eastern. We've cooked soul food.
You are
We've
good.
Cooked Cajun food, Italian. We've had a couple of brides that have given us a grandma's recipe.
That's
because grandma's no longer with them, and they wanted that her
that
to be
special
part of
recipe.
Their day. So they gave me recipes. We tried it out. They loved it. I guess I did it right. And
she kept it.
and they served it at the wedding. So, you know, it's to me, especially corporate events are different. But to me, weddings, family reunions have to be part of that, your heritage. I don't care what it is.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We do, you know, at Easter time, I was brought up, that you ate lamb at Easter. My grandparents were Syrian Orthodox, and in that tradition, you had lamb at Easter because Christ was the Lamb of God. And so we had Middle Eastern food at Easter. My husband hates lamb. So for about
don't tell me you tricked them.
First 20 years we didn't have lamb at Easter.
Okay.
Now we have both. We have all your traditional Easter foods, and we do Middle Eastern food as well.
That's crazy. I know my mom with 8 children and tons of grandchildren used to cook all the time. Well, on Sundays when you come over, the entire table is filled with food. But then as she got older, she got tired of that. She's like, I am tired of cooking all these foods. And you come over on a Sunday and, well, do you ever get tired of cooking? Do you ever be like, look, honey, go in there and eat a bowl of cereal. That's what I cook. I can make a mean bowl of cornflakes. Hello. But do you get tired of that?
Oh, sometime? On occasion. Yeah. But we've never been people who, excuse me.
Chassidy will pull out that Uzi and shoot you if you shoot. You go away.
I've
no,
got just, this drainage with this allergy stuff going around.
That's all
right. But, yeah, on occasion, and we'll go out to dinner from time to time. But my husband was raised with, there were 9 of them in their family.
So he probably know how to cook, too.
he's doing better the last many years. He's retired. And so it's really been a blessing when I've been really busy with clients, with meetings or networking events. He will have dinner ready for me when I get
home. Aw, now that's a good husband.
Yep.
That is a great husband.
Hopefully after
Tim,
50 years.
Tim, did you hear that?
I wasn't paying any attention. What she said?
Of course he's not. He's not paying attention.
Did you hear that, honey? Okay, so tell me what we have in front of us, because this is something delicious looking, and I already know it tastes delicious.
It is a Bailey's chocolate mousse with some chocolate chip, white chocolate chip. Chips.
Pick it up and show it to the camera before okay. it disappears.
And
in
then
that
it's
cup.
Got a little mini vanilla wafer on it. We don't do cakes.
So you don't do the wedding cakes?
Oh gosh, no. It might taste good, but it definitely wouldn't look good. It would be lopsided probably.
You tried it?
No. I just know how my normal cakes turn out. But we've done desserts. You know, we do different desserts. And
your favorite dessert to make is?
Baklava.
That sounds hard to do.
It's time consuming. It takes about 3 to 4 hours to make it. It
doesn't really take that long. That's why it's so delicious.
Yeah. Well, you've got to make a homemade syrup. And, you know, I usually only make it once a year. Wow. Because it's time consuming and I just you only have the time to do that.
So. Okay, so but you like cooking, right?
Yeah.
So what if I just need you to help me with a meal?
Sure. That's easy.
Do you have a number like, okay, I'm going to hire you to come cook dinner for me and Tim, where you say, no, the minimum is 4 or the minimum is...
We, you know, we don't do personal chef stuff, but we do dinner parties for 8 to 10 people. We just did one it was 25, but we've done
so
that.
So you already have it pre-made when you come to their home or you get in their kitchen and slam down.
Yeah.
No, wouldn't you think right now that you'd get just a ton of those 8 to 25 callings because you can't take your business meeting to the restaurant anymore?
Busy. Well, and that's, you know, when we got started, I did weekly meals for people, and you know, that were too busy or did not like to go out to dinner. So we took orders and we did probably about 10 different families. We did weekly meals. Then it got, when we started doing a lot more of events, that got to be
too much.
Too much.
Yeah.
We couldn't do it.
That's crazy. So do I get to taste that?
Sure.
You know, pass one to my guests and let them tell me. Tell me the ingredients in this deliciousness.
It is chocolate pudding, whipping cream, and Bailey's.
I am so serious. Slide the dessert to me.
Tim, do you want one?
Yes. Because I'm not giving him ice.
Well, I got 2 more here, so he can have one.
That is work. Here we go.
So.
There you go.
Oh, isn't that nice?
It's very nice. And the centerpiece, by the way, that you're looking at. Yes, get a look at it before it disappears. Yes.
It makes it disappear. Hocus
pocus. It's done.
So for your centerpieces, do you make all the centerpieces yourself?
I actually have my front of the house manager does a lot of that. This book has some of the stuff that we do, and she is awesome with putting, she gets in and she sets up the tables with decorations. We'll customize to fit our
someone's
clients'
vision,
decor,
right. What they have.
You know, they'll say we're doing we're doing a family reunion that's all like a cowboy type theme because this is Texas and they're doing a family reunion, so they're doing Texas stuff. So we're going to paint.
What's this crunchy that I just had right here? What's
that? Is white chocolate.
White chocolate, girl.
So. She's great at putting that kind of stuff together, and she gets in there, and within about 10 minutes, that whole table is set up and looks pretty, and it's decorated in the colors that our clients are looking to decorate their guest tables.
That is awesome. Mm. You take care of everything.
We try.
You take the worry out, because that is very important.
Yeah, you know, we work with a lot of great coordinators, and like I said, we're a preferred vendor at 4 venues in the Metroplex, and they have awesome staff. So it's real easy when you work with somebody a long time.
Yeah, that's cool to have, too.
It's really easy. They know what to expect from us, and we know what to expect from them. And it's really great.
That is so great. Well, Devon, what do you think? You like it?
Chassidy. It's really tasty.
I'm trying to eat like a lady over here.
She's like,
I wait till the cameras go off and I'm
gonna get it down.
Take it back. What do you think?
I think it's absolutely delicious. And one quick note, John Groves said, loving that hat, Chassidy.
Thank you.
Sorry, I got dibs on that one, baby. But that is very, that's very good. So,
the centerpieces, they're here. You do all the centerpieces, right?
Yeah, Whitney does.
You ever had a project that you just couldn't do? You'll never tell anyone I can't.
No, we try not to.
Right.
You know, there are times that sometimes we'll have to call if they want something more than what we're used to doing. I have a couple of planners and decorators that I can call on to say, hey, give us a hands up on this. We're not sure how to handle it, or we want to do it. They want something more upscale than we're used to.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's a lot of great people out there that we can call on for help and
that's
assistance
cool.
if we need it.
A good network.
Yes,
where you can network
really,
in with everybody.
Yeah.
So how do you keep up with the trends? You know, things change, things get, you know,
yep,
how do you keep up with
change,
all that?
Taste change in what we do. I'm on the advisory board for TCC.
TCC stands for?
Tarrant Community College. Okay, so I've been on the advisory board for 5 years. And we have some great people that are chefs, people that work for and have been part of like Benny Keith and other restaurant supplies that are really helpful in teaching the kids what the new stuff is. And then we also get all that information. So it's really, it's a really good networking as well as helping the kids being on the right track with what they're doing.
You sound like, and I believe, I ain't gonna curse, but you got your stuff together.
We try.
You know what I mean?
We try.
It's apparent that you have a passion for what you do.
I do.
You didn't quit in 2 years or 6 years. You're in 20-plus years in doing what you're doing.
Like I said, I love cooking and I love people.
Are you going to pass some of this down to the grandchildren?
I have one daughter that works for me, and she's really been a blessing on days where my husband has some health issues.
Mm-hmm.
And so on days when I really feel like I need to be at the house, and she will she takes jobs with other staff, and she'll...
What is her name?
Whitney.
Shout out to you, Whitney. That's what's up.
Yeah, she's really great at doing that. But I have really awesome staff that are really helpful. Whitney's worked for me when she was a teenager, and then she came back to work with me when her youngest son was born. Esther is a lady that's about my age, and she's just terrific at organizing.
That's great.
She does the back
of the
house.
Team.
Yeah, and our other staff is just, it's great. They're very helpful. They're very considerate of the clients that we have when they're serving them. They're considerate of each other. They're friendly, but they're not overwhelming. I mean, they're not obnoxious
mm-hmm.
with how they, you know, talk to people or...
Mm-hmm.
They're just great. We have one of the staff that Rolana says that she's my fourth daughter. I mean, they're great people.
It's good to have a good team,
yes.
team like that.
It makes a big difference.
Oh, believe you me, I know.
Makes a big difference.
I believe you me, I know. Sometimes it matters even if you have a good neighbor. Because I'm not going to talk about my neighbors.
Well, we have awesome neighbors.
I am
so
not
going
to
okay.
talk about them neighbors. They're there for a reason. Maybe it's to keep me on my P's and Q's. I don't know. But it is what it is. I love what you're doing. But, you know, we all are human.
Yeah.
Donna, you're human. Donna, you're a busy girl. Donna, you're doing a lot of things. But Donna gets stressed, too. How do you handle that?
Sometimes it's just going and sitting in one of the bedrooms and watching one of my favorite shows.
Which is?
Kind of just unwind. Oh, gosh. I have bunches of them.
Do you like comedy?
Yeah, I like comedy. One of my, and I'm really upset that they're canceling it this year, but I like to watch Empire. I love music.
You know what? It is so weird. Tim is into the Empire. I've been too busy to even watch Empire. I am
my
so
my husband is not big on that.
This is the season finale, though, right?
I know.
Yeah, this is it.
I know it's upsetting because I love music. And so, to me, it's just relaxing. I know they're arguing and they're throwing things at each other, but to me, it's sitting back and watching one of my favorite shows sometimes is just, it's unwind, you know. I Blue Bloods, just Bob Hart's Abishola, if you've never seen that, it's the cutest show.
What is it called?
It's called Bob Hart's Abishola.
I've never heard of that.
And it's a comedy, and it's just refreshing. I believe it's on four. I think it's on Fox.
It's on Fox.
Yeah, it's on Fox. So I just like to, that's how I unwind most of the time.
Well, good. At least you have some avenues to unwind and get it done. You didn't say, oh, I don't know.
Self-care.
Right?
They look different for everybody.
I love it.
It is. It is. Everybody handles stress and self-care in different ways.
Yes.
They really do.
And it's important that they find that way.
Oh, definitely.
You know, and not stay so stuck in on it.
Yeah, because that can drive you nuts.
Yes, it can.
It
really can. Well, for life celebrated moments, look no further. If you're in a DFW. But do you go outside DFW?
Oh, yeah. We've gone as far as Waco. And then, of course, you got your outer lying areas like Anna and Denison. We're doing a wedding.
You charge for that travel, right?
We charge for travel.
Yeah, Waco's a good four-hour drive. So,
it was,
know.
Yeah. Waco was that was a stressful
That's
one.
A good drive, yeah.
Yeah. But, and, you know, Denison, we're doing an event at in Denton. So we the Metroplex is our main, you know, hub.
Mm-hmm.
But we do go out without, you know, on the outskirts of the Metroplex as well.
Do I need to contact you? How much in advance for my event before you can handle that? I know you have a lot of clients.
Sometimes, you know, we have somebody that just booked us and their wedding is in 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. We had somebody book us 2 weeks before their wedding. It was a young couple, and they were going to just do cake and punch, and I guess parents said, no, this is lunchtime. We got to serve people something. So
wow.
But normally between 4 to 6 months, people book us for weddings.
Right.
Corporate events and stuff, not as early. But weddings usually 4 to 6 months because there's so much involved in a wedding.
This is that
yeah, most people have a wedding planner to handle some of that. If you're just waiting the last minute, come on now.
Right.
Sometimes. So, but we've worked with some great wedding planners. So, you know, we really feel blessed with
so
that.
So I know, you know, we all know that there's a lot of squirrels trying to get a nut. That's my favorite saying. That means, you know, I'm sorry. That just means that you're not the only catering company out
right.
there. There's other catering companies and event planners. So I know why, but tell the camera, tell the people why they need to come and check out.
Well,
your
number one, we're small, so we give a lot of personal attention. When we finish a wedding in particular, we usually have brides, grooms, sometimes mom or dad come and thank us for helping making their day special. But when you're smaller, you can give that more personal attention. We customize our menus to fit our clients, be it a wedding or a corporate event or a house party, and that's a big deal. A mm-hmm. lot of caterers don't do that. And if it's a nonprofit or, you know, military, police, firemen, we give a discount, which a lot of people don't do.
Wow.
So I think we have a lot of things to offer people that maybe a larger caterer doesn't. I'm not saying they can't. I'm just saying a lot of them don't.
Mm-hmm.
And we have terrific staff.
I was going to say, we both know we've had a few marriages between us, Queen.
Yes, we have.
And we know that, yeah, sometimes your catering menu is pretty limited in scope. They say, this is what we offer, and pick one of the six.
Yeah, we've never done that.
And it's kind of nice to have a refreshing caterer out there that says, well, what do you want?
Yeah, this past week, we had four different tastings, and it was really ironic. We had three of them that all wanted Cajun food. So we did a lot of Cajun food this past week for tastings.
Wow.
So
something that you don't know how to cook, you'll school yourself and do it, right?
We will look for it. Like I said, we've had, you know, clients give us a recipe even.
You go with the gluten-free and
yes,
all that stuff that they do.
Yes, we've done some gluten-free. We did an all-vegan wedding a year and a half ago, and I really felt great about that. She had contacted about 20 caterers in the Metroplex. Only four responded to her.
Wow.
And then she liked the variety of what we gave her and did their wedding.
That's what's up.
Hmm.
You don't turn nobody down.
We try.
You like,
not
you
to.
Know what? I am in this game for 20 years. How much money you got? I'm going to figure out how to do something for you, right? I mean,
yes,
you are
ma'am.
Affordable. I've been waiting to hear that word affordable in
oh,
there.
Oh, yeah. We really are.
You work with the person.
We really do. And we have three daughters, paid for all three of their weddings. I know how expensive weddings can be. Corporate events usually have a nice budget.
Budget, yeah.
But with a wedding, you don't just have a caterer or a venue. You have photographers. You have DJs.
Right.
You have flowers. You
right.
have a venue.
Right.
Invitations. Right. The whole ball of wax. And so we really try to work within their budget.
That's good.
That's real important to me.
That is really
Our
good.
Last daughter broke the bank when she got married. So
she broke your bank?
So, but weddings are different than corporate events.
That's what's up. You know, I really appreciate you taking the time out of your busy day, because I know that you could be somewhere else doing something else. That
it
you could be doing something
pleasure.
Else. And I appreciate you. I appreciate Chassidy, Devon. I appreciate you all taking the time and coming in on the Queen Silvy Show. It makes me feel special.
Well, you probably
feel so special.
You are, you
gonna
are
just,
special.
That tear is going to blink out that left eye. Right,
I want to make the right eye cry.
Huh?
I want to make the right eye cry.
Yeah, so
the left
the
eye,
right eye
cry.
Cries only Tim can do.
Ah.
I got that one down.
Yeah, he got that
ah,
one.
Okay.
That right eye. And I'm going to tell you when I knew that he had it, because after our very first date, the first date we had, now, I was already coming out of a divorce.
Uh-huh.
And I was leery. I studied and looked him up. That's when I learned the internet, what all you can find. But after that first date, and we lived in different cities, 30 days later, he drove from his city to my city in a U-Haul to get his queen. Hello. And I was like, what? I didn't even do number drink wine on that first day. Hello. I didn't give it up.
Yeah.
I was
like,
giving
was
it up
it that
on my
good?
First day. I'm like, what did I do? What did I do? But that 30 days turned into 12 years.
There you go.
So.
Oh, y'all married.
Oh
yeah,
that's what I was telling you. I said he likes me.
Oh, he likes
me. He just likes me.
Okay.
Hi, Yella.
My type of light skin. Okay.
But yeah. So you know, what can I say?
Beautiful. I love
well,
it.
That was John and I met. I had to get rid of a girlfriend of his. Got rid of her. We started dating.
Oh, you bumped her out the way with your
yes,
cooking,
ma'am.
Didn't you? You was like, yeah.
Met in June, started dating in September, and the following July, we got married.
Wow. That's awesome. Well, since we're doing all of these stories, I'm going to have Chassidy come back and tell me, whoever that was asking those questions probably try to find you. He want to know some things, and I'm like, okay, so we're going to have Chassidy come back on the show and tell us about one of these dates that's probably finna happen. Chastity.
Oh, no dates, no dates.
Why?
No dates.
Why not?
I'm taking.
Look at her. She over there blinking her eyes like.
I'm taking.
Committed, taken. You better say the word committed, because some men out there be like, she just said taken. I could take that. You just heard Donna. Donna swooped up her husband, took it.
Yeah. I swooped up one, took him from somebody. So.
You're good.
I'm going on
So tell me, what would you be looking for, Chassidy? What is the perfect friend? Three? Okay. The perfect friend. The
friend?
Well, I mean, you got to start out friends first. That's important.
With him, we were friends. Like, we were really cool. We always...
Friends first, right?
We were very... Like,
See?
He would call all the time. With the type of society that we are, people just don't have, like, a communication where he will pick up the phone and say, hey, how you doing? Like, just calling and communicating with me was super important. And just finding common interest and... laughing and joking and being able to be real with each other,
yep.
That builds, and then you know a couple of months later you're like, oh, I really like this person.
Yeah,
so.
They taking notes like she said. Yeah. And then she said, so.
Just make me
up.
Laugh and keep it real with me.
That's all
take
right.
Take me on lunches. I like to eat.
Me too.
Oh,
we're going
too.
To do that in a minute. Donna, tell everybody how you can be followed and contacted for services for unique catering and party
planning.
You can
call at 817-975-0217. We have websites, www.uniquedonna.com. Take a look at what we have to offer on the website. It kind of gives you a general idea of our pricing and what we can do. But like I said before, we customize to fit what you want, not what we can cook.
That's what's up. You have some cards with you?
I do.
Leave me some cards,
sure.
If you will. I thank you for taking the time coming on.
Oh, it's
and,
my
and
pleasure.
Getting my appetite started. Look. It's time to really grub now, boy, I tell you.
that or drink. I'm just kidding. I just keep kidding you. I'm just kidding. Just kidding.
The whole bottle is at the house in the bar. So, you know.
And that bottle might be in my trunk. No, I'm just kidding. I am seriously just kidding. I can kid if I want to. But you know what? I thank you for being here on the show. If you are a talent and you'd like to be on the Queen Silvy Show, we'd love to have you. Hit me up at queensylviacomic.com. You can follow me on the webpage, www.queensylviacomedy.com. I'm on Facebook and Instagram under Sylvie Starks or Queen Silvy. No, I don't twerk, Twitter, or tweet.
Tim? She'll be twerking soon.
Huh?
You'll be twerking soon.
There you go. You can follow me, Tim McGiffin.
I just can't tell. It's in a chair. I'm like... Did you see it?
That's all you need.
That's it.
The chair twerk is the best.
I'm sorry. Go for it, Tim. Tim, you can be followed by
Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, Tim McGiffin.
That's what's up. I thank you all for tuning in to the Queen Silvy Show. Tune in next week. We always keep it real with the best in the entertainment industry, business, and all that just for you. Go out and enjoy your terrific Tuesday. Make it terrific because we woke up today. So make the best of that day, right? And check out Chase and Chassidy. Definitely wait because we're going to have her back on the show as well as life coach Detox. Tell me that again.
Coach D.
Coach D right here, as well as Donna Sellers with Unique Catering and Party Planning. Thank you all for tuning in. We're going to get on out of here with.
With what?
That's what I want.
How about mastering? How about some commercials? And
we're out of here.
We're out of here.
All right. Go out and enjoy your day, Queen Silvy. Y'all.
Hi, this is Manny Anseldu of The Art of Manifesting Your Desires, broadcasting live every Monday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. from Globe Life Park in Arlington, Texas. Join me as we discuss what the law...